Well, some Maryland families fully expected they'd be in their new homes by now, but the contractor they hired is facing criminal charges.
The 11 News I-Team first told you about it back in November. Tonight, I-Team reporter Barry Sims has new information on how the deal worked. He's live now in the studio with an update. Barry?
Right, and Marianne, the last time we talked to Michael Conrad, he told us he was not going to answer any more questions. Tonight, some of the families who say they paid him to build their homes are still seeking answers to their financial struggles.
I'd like to talk to you on camera, please.
You're not going to talk on camera.
We approached Michael Conrad just before he was indicted on forgery and theft charges in November. Conrad, also known as Michael Conrad Brown, is the subject of investigations by Prince George's County and Maryland's Attorney General. Now the I-Team has learned new details about Conrad's company, Westwood Design Build, his business deals.
We're strapped. You know, we're out of a lot of money. We have land, nothing on the land.
And the lingering financial problems plaguing some of his customers.
He took me to National City. He said that's where he normally does all of his loans with.
June Polydor says under Conrad's instruction, she got a construction loan through National City Mortgage. Benjamin and Eva Hebron and Barry and Tony Postel say they did too. Conrad is accused of illegally taking hundreds of thousands of dollars from the loans and never building the homes he promised the families. Prince George's County State's Attorney Glenn Ivey says in cases like this, the goals are the same.
We want to make sure we do everything we can to prosecute that case and to get restitution for the victims to make sure that they can be whole or, you know, get as close as we can to making them whole at the end of that process.
The Hebrons say Conrad promised to build this 7-bedroom home on their Anne Arundel County property for $160,000. All they have now is a mound of dirt and old concrete on the spot where their old home was demolished.
I don't know whether or not we can ever get another builder or we can ever get somebody else, but maybe somebody could see how much damage this man has done to my parents. Could maybe step up. Maybe another construction company can step up.
The Hebron's daughter, Carolyn, says months after the new construction was to be over, National City called.
When they called me and said, Miss Hebron, how do you like your new home? And I'm saying, what new home? Man, we don't have the first foundation yet. She said, excuse me? She said, well, you know what, Ms. Hebron, let me look into this.
The I-Team contacted the mortgage company. A spokesman says National City is looking into mortgages related to Westwood Design Build, but we do not speak publicly about ongoing internal investigations.
All I want at this moment in time is for me to get out to this whole deal and move on.
But she can't. Polydor expected to build a $300,000 house on this uncleared lot she purchased from Conrad. To ensure her credit rating doesn't fall, she says she continues making the $1,700 a month loan payment, and she's also paying the mortgage on her present house. Despite that, she received this letter from the mortgage company.
National City has determined that construction of the improvements, as defined in your construction loan documents, has not progressed in accordance with your construction permanent loan agreement.
The company threatened to foreclose because there is no new home. Polydor says she pleaded with National City.
So I thought they would have some sympathy on me. At least I didn't ask not to pay anything. I said, can you cap my rate? Can you reduce my interest payment?
The Postels and the Hebrons also say they contacted National City, and the company told them about an internal investigation. But then...
we got this bill from the bank with 6 or 7 months of payments that, you know, we want this money, or we're going to call this loan due.
National City will not comment on each individual case, but says, in general, when customers have problems making mortgage payments, we work with them to find the best possible solutions for their situations. But now the families have hired lawyers to sort this all out as the investigations into the dealings of Michael Conrad and Westwood continue.
And the I-Team tried but was unable to get a comment from Michael Conrad's attorney. Conrad previously told the I-Team he stopped building because of the down economy. And in the case of the Hebron family, he said he spent more than the Hebrons paid dealing with problems related to their site. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm Barry Sims.